Yo, what's going on, guys? JBH here, and today I am back on rFactor 2 for some more action in the Formula E category. Today, we're in Germany for the Berlin e-Prix, or recreating the Berlin e-Prix that was supposed to take place in 2020. I'm not sure if it is still going to take place. I haven't really been following the news too much with Formula E series. But anyway, we are starting off of dead last because I do have no pace here whatsoever. 22-minute race, so half of what it is in real life. Standing start. Oh, here we go. Let's just try and survive the first lap. Smash it in first. A little bit of wheel spin. The first corner is just a long, long left-hander, but boxed in here. Oh, tap. Around the outside. You. Three spots. Got to somehow get double file for this one. Over the curbs. Alright, made up a couple spots. Ooh. Tried to get two. We got one, but that's alright. We are moving forward. No balls, Joseph. Come on. Cold tyres, that one. That is sketchy. Right, now into the tightest corner on the track. Power down. Around the final corner, and that one is pretty much in the books. Made up a good 8 spots. Just went around the outside of turn one, and it seemed to be where the biggest gain was, but still got ages left. Oh. And it's so hard when you're braking turning these cars. Oh. Ah, come on, Joseph. It's terrible. Good through the first set. Second sector, I guess, this sector, but first and last one were pretty bad. Too much rear bias. Slamming down the gears, locking it up. Surface around here is really, really slippery compared to some of the other tracks we've been on this year. Driving like scheisse. Already losing the cars ahead by like a second a lap here. Just wants the wheel spin. Terrible first couple of laps. Since a really good first lap. Just do not trust the car at all around here. Got a train of cars behind us. Still 17 odd minutes to go. No pit stops. So we've got to try and get to the end purely on pace. No strategy. Track just has no grip. Well, I have no grip. Behind us, but one of the sort of major aspects of Formula E is the whole energy saving or battery saving where you sort of have to drive the car to get the battery to the end of the race, but we don't have to do that on rFactor 2 because I've set it to sort of unlimited, mainly because the AI can't do it or don't have the ability to do it. So try a second round here, slower. So yeah, we won't have to worry about that. We can just flat to the floor to the end. So slow. What we need is some of the guys to make some mistakes in front of us. Just clearing off into the distance. We're gonna have to drive defensively for the 16th place spot the rest of the race. That's 8 seconds ahead, Jesus Christ. Why am I so slow? Ich verstehe nicht. Slightly better than that, but still well off the pace. Much, much better lap. Sort of gapped the guys behind just a little bit. Still miles away from the guys in front. crap lap. Starting to use those rears up. Oh, shit. What happened through turn one there? Just could not get it turned. Definitely overheating these rears. Desperately trying to hold on to this 17th place. No, that's not gone well. Damn it! Tried second just to see if I could pull it off. See if it would be quicker, but obviously not. Damn it! Bomb one up the inside here. Oh, hello! Okay, that's one way to do it. Fighting for the final couple of positions, but it's a good racing nonetheless. Tell I do not have the pace for these guys in front. Oh, it's getting hot in here. Overheat these rears. Nothing left. And the numbers look fine, but just feel they're constantly going away more and more each lap. car is not handling well at all. Now we got still 7 minutes far out. Right now. I say that, it's not that hot, it's just that there's no air conditioning, so it's like 30 degrees inside this house. Oh my god, barely gonna hold on to this much longer. Let's just try not to finish last. That's our challenge for today. Five minutes to go. Hang it out. Come on, we need this checkered flag to come, or else we're gonna finish literally dead last. Down into the yellow. She's gone, skis. Problem is, I used up so much of the tyre early on to try and stay with the back in front. Oh, no, that's a fence. I have none now, but I had to use it just to try and stay with the back in front. Oh my god, this thing is just completely has no grip anymore. It's locking up all four tyres. No, we must not finish last. Dive bomb, three wide. Battle for the wooden spoon is on. Seconds behind the car in front. Man, we are so slow, it's embarrassing. Should probably have turned the AI down a little bit. But I felt we were 9/10 off in practice, and I felt we could go a little bit quicker, but the AI get quicker as they get into the race on rFactor 2. Which is a little bit backwards compared to real life, but it is what it is. No. Man, I'm sweating like a pig. Right, two laps to go, come on. Overshot there a little bit. Oh, they're fine behind us. This is good. Do not want the wooden spoon. Whole way out of there, it's just spinning it up. It's definitely the surface. I don't know what it is about this track. Oh no, 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 that's in the marbles. Woo. Something about this track has just got no grip whatsoever. The AI are fine, but you can sort of set them to have whatever grip they want through the AI difficulty setting, but got it all sorts wrong here. Anyway, we've had some battles. We've defended basically the entire race, and this is the last lap, so let's just get this thing to the finish line without grabbing the wooden spoon to go with it. Still fighting, come on. Alright, and around the final corner, we're not going to finish last, so mission accomplished, but yeah, pretty dismal race, or for the most part. We got a good first lap, but since the start, we were absolutely terrible, just no pace whatsoever. I mean, no grip, and they're all down in the yellow. That's the most tire wear I've had of any race so far this year in the Formula E car, but anyway, that's that. Thanks guys for tuning in. Apologies it wasn't a little bit more towards the pointy end, but always fun to check out some of these tracks, the special sort of e-Prix circuits, and this car as well. I mean, I hate this car, to be honest. It's just so backwards to everything I know, but the tracks itself are good fun, and the AI is pretty decent as well. So anyway, thanks guys for tuning in. Stay tuned for more throughout the year, and until next time, I'll catch you guys later.